My name's Julia Day and I'm a lecturer in environmental biology at UCL, but I also have a position as a scientific associate here at the Natural History Museum. And this is a really nice synergy for me because it means that I can access the collections and I can, when I'm out collecting, I can deposit my collections here at the museum and integrate my collections with the historic collections that we find here. Down here, all the cichlids from Lake Tanganyika. This shelf here are Cynodontis catfish, which are also endemic to Lake Tanganyika. And down here are some undescribed species, which we need to work on. I was interested particularly in Lake Tanganyika because we really find a whole variety of life there. You have a region which is really, it's a hotspot of biodiversity, and you've got so many different species living there. So it's very important for me to go to the lake myself and start collecting fish. Interestingly, on a recent visit to Lake Tanganyika, we've discovered a new species. So maybe I can show this to you now. So this is something that actually my colleague found. This is in Zambia. So this is the south of Lake Tanganyika. And these are spiny eels. So you can see they're sort of, at the minute, preserved in ethanol. So we can then use the DNA from these samples. Normally they're quite pigmented, so they have a lot of colour on them. You can quite clearly see from this, there's no pigmentation at all. The other thing to note, and why we know this is a new species, is it hasn't got any pectoral fins. So the pectoral fin would be around here on the body. You go on a collecting trip to the lake, you are finding new species, which is obviously quite exciting. It's really important for us to be concerned about biodiversity and the loss of biodiversity. For example, the lakes which I work on, for example, Lake Tanganyika, here we've got a lot of deforestation going along the lake, particularly on the Tanzanian border. With the deforestation, the soils are obviously becoming very unstable on the sides of the lake, and you're getting a lot of sedimentation running off into the lake. Now this causes the turbidity of the lake to increase. With the cichlid fishes, for example, a lot of their cues are based on the coloration of the males. Now, when we've got increased turbidity, that's obviously disrupting their ability for the females to detect which males they should mate with. And that's causing hybridization and therefore a loss of species. So I think, you know, I'm just talking about one lake, but obviously, you know, this extends to other systems around the world. I think it's really important for younger scientists or new scientists to continue the tradition of collecting. It's really important for us to understand the biodiversity on our planet. We have amazing collections here at the museum for scientists like myself to study. And with my collections, I'm also building on that and generating a new resource for future scientists.